Well, the government calls your company. It could be the FBI, it could be the Department of Justice fraud section responsible for the Foreign Corrupt Practices Act, or it could be some other federal agency. Who do you call? I'm the kind of person you call. I'm a federal regulatory compliance attorney with a lot of experience in dealing with the criminal investigations of these matters and a lot of experience advising companies in how to get through these kinds of investigations and inquiries. You need, first and foremost, the ability to think critically. You need to look at what is in the record as well as what is not there. You need to be able to conduct an interview of an employee in such a way that the employee will give you a complete answer. You also need the ability to write well. You can't text the response to these kinds of investigations. They're just too complex. You need to be able to organize information, because at the end of the day, when you're talking to our government about serious matters, you need to present information that is grounded in fact. You need to be able to teach yourself, because the facts are always going to be different and you need to find them and teach them to yourself. Secondly, the law is not going to be the law as it's reflected in a law book. It's going to be the law applied to the facts in the particular circumstance. Sometimes you need the ability to work effectively through other persons. That could be employees of the company that you need to engage to go find the information efficiently and effectively, or it might be outside resources such as forensic accounting firms who will be needed to look at electronic documents, to capture images of computers, and to be able to search them to find what you need to do the job for your client. Look, there's no shortage of lawyers in California or pretty much in the United States. Most of the work I do is done by what I call big law. These are law firms with hundreds of lawyers, typically diverse geographic locations, and most frequently actually global law firms. But there's always room and a need for good lawyers, better lawyers, and for the best lawyer in the particular field. So if this is something that you will be good at, it's worth pursuing. Be patient. Go to law school only if you find law and the processes of law interesting. My path to big law involved three steps. First, it involved government service, where I learned about the government and its practices and its expectations. Next, I went to work for a Fortune 100 company which conducts business that is regulated by the U.S. government. And I learned about the reporting obligations and the compliance obligations and how business works. And only after 20 years of experience did I go to big law, which these companies depend on for the resolution of these kinds of issues. I would encourage you to look at the American Bar Association Journal, the California Bar Association Journal, and the reports issued by the committees within those two organizations for public contract law, international law, and white-collar criminal law.